Are you ever creating an ad and seeing all of the switches and toggles and buttons and wondering which ones should you use and which ones should you avoid? Today we're gonna walk through 9 features, plus at the end I'm gonna share with you my favorite type of ad objective. This one can make all the difference if you're not already using it. Let's start here with an orientation of where we're headed in this tutorial. I'm going to show you some features at the campaign level, at the ad set level, and at the ad level. To get to your campaign level, go to business.facebook.com/ads manager. If you're not in the right account, go ahead and click your little pull down right here and select the account that you want to be inside of. Let's start at our campaign settings. I went ahead and set up an example campaign here, but if you needed to set up your own campaign, you're gonna click create right here on the left. The dialog box will walk you through setting up a new campaign. To get into your campaign, you're gonna click this little edit button right here at your campaign level. The first little feature that we get asked a lot about is the A/B test feature. If I have a limited budget or a shorter time frame, I typically do my own manual testing process. If you're interested, you can click over to that and learn how to do your own manual testing on a small budget and in a shorter time frame. If you have a bigger budget, I love the A/B test feature, and that's something you could definitely play with. To get started with it, you're simply going to click this button right here that says get started. The next feature that is usually defaulted to on is the campaign budget optimization. This is a feature that is both famous and infamous on Facebook. Some people love it and some people hate it. Which camp do you fall into? Let me know in the comments below. For the sake of this test, I'm going to go ahead and leave this button on. Campaign budget optimization basically sets the budget at the campaign level versus the ad set level. You might have, let's say, 3 or 4 or 5 ads sets inside of your campaign. If you have this little button toggled on, Facebook is going to disperse that budget that you set at the campaign level across all of your ad sets. Some ad sets may get a lot more of your budget and other ad sets may get a lot less. So if you're doing a bunch of audience testing, or if you have a lot of ad sets that you want to test, campaign budget optimization may not be your best friend. If you want to test, let's say, 4 or 5 audiences that you already know are real winners for you, this is a great place to turn on campaign budget optimization. It can have the impact of really optimizing your results and getting you the lowest cost per result possible. Now let's move into the ad set and turn on some features there. You can navigate to the ad set by clicking right here on this left-hand menu or up here right in the middle on this top menu. You can also navigate to your ad set by clicking the blue hyperlink at your campaign level or checking this little box and then clicking your ad set tab in the middle right here. Lots of ways to get into your ad set. At your ad set level, if you are using lookalikes, then you might have noticed this little feature. It is this little button that appears right below your custom audience that says lookalike expansion. I've been experimenting with this and so far it has done wonders for my ad costs. So click it and give it a try. Another button that people often ask me about is the detailed targeting expansion. If you're targeting an audience in your detailed targeting and you click this little button right here below, this will expand the audience to other people who might also be interested in your ads. For both of these expansion buttons, what I recommend doing is doing one audience with the expansion turned on and one audience or ad set with the expansion turned off. Then you can compare apples to apples and see how these little buttons are working for you. Now, once we scroll down in the ad set, I often get asked about this: auto placements versus manual placements. I always recommend doing the auto placements. Some people think that they want to do manual placements because maybe they don't have an Instagram account. The good news is you don't have to have an Instagram account to run ads on Instagram. In fact, a good portion of your budget when you select auto placements is going to Instagram. So even if you didn't know you were doing Instagram ads, you're automatically doing them when you select auto placements. At your ad set level, right under the conversion box, you're gonna see this little feature called Dynamic Creative. I think it's one of the best features on Facebook Ads Manager. So I'm gonna go ahead and toggle that on and show you exactly how to use it. So what Dynamic Creative does is make different combinations of your ad creative and deliver them to people who historically love images or love videos or love gifts or love long copy or short copy. And it allows Facebook to really customize this for each individual, which is pretty awesome. In order to use this, you're going to toggle the button on right here. And then at the ad level, this is where you can add in all of your creative elements. The first thing that you're going to do is select your images, videos, and gifts. You can select existing assets or you can upload new ones. Since I already have a lot of existing assets in my account, I'm just gonna pull these in. You can have a maximum of 10 videos, images, GIFs, and slideshows. The next thing that you can add in are your text variations. And how I found this feature to work best is when you're just adding in a couple variations of your winning copy. If you have not gone through a manual testing process yet with your copy and your imagery and your headlines, I highly recommend doing that before you utilize this feature. And again, if you need a refresher on how to run these manual tests, I've got the link in the description below. The next thing that you're going to add in are a couple of your top performing headlines. You can do that right here. If you want to add in multiple descriptions, this is the little line of text that lives right below the headline. You can go ahead and do that here. Next is the call to actions. You can click on this little pull down menu to get all of the options and select the ones which are most applicable to your ads. The next feature is actually related to dynamic creative. So it's this little toggle button right here, which allows you to optimize all of these creative elements for each individual person. If you're using dynamic creative, go ahead and toggle this little button on. This again is just allowing Facebook to combine all of these elements into a really individualized experience for each individual person who sees your ads. As you scroll down at the ad level, right under the description, you're going to see this little feature called optimized text per person. Hover over the optimized text per person, click edit, and then simply toggle that on. This is going to allow your text to kind of swap between fields. So your headline could become your primary copy, for example. Now, this is a really smart tool, and don't worry, it's only gonna draw from copy that you have already written and that you've already selected to go into your ad. But it's really cool, and I've seen that the results are really, really good. So go ahead and flip that on and see how it does for you too. Before I get into my last tip, let me just assure you that you can layer all of these together. Anything that I mentioned that is good to turn on, just turn it on and see how it does. I think you'll love your results. And the final thing that I want to take you through is my favorite type of ad objective. At the campaign level, you're going to see three columns with different objective types. My favorite type, hands down, are conversion ads. These ads are, in my opinion, the most powerful type of ads that you can run that really tell Facebook to optimize for emails or phone numbers, credit card transactions, if you have an e-commerce storefront, for example, but it does come with a couple of setup steps. So you need to install the pixel on your website. You need to verify your domain and do a few little housekeeping tasks like that. But if you're up for it, I highly recommend that the majority of your budget gets spent on conversion ads. Now, for this video, I created a special playlist just for you so you can learn how to install your pixel, verify your domain, set up your events, and also go through that testing protocol. I'll see you in the next video.